First tonight, travellers are stranded at some of the country's largest airports as thick ash from a Chilean volcano grounds flights. Cancellations are predicted right through until Wednesday as airlines put safety first. We have reporters at the worst affected airports, but before we go to them, the latest on a day of delays.
Delayed and waiting, more than 5,000 passengers across Australia forced into a holding pattern as a Chilean volcano continues its rumblings.
Our flight was cancelled due to a volcano and a volcano cloud coming from Chile, and we just thought it was a hoax.
Dozens of international and domestic flights from Sydney, Brisbane and Melbourne were grounded as a thick ash cloud stretches across New Zealand and Tasmania. Airlines scrambled to make alternative plans, while Qantas alone cancelled more than 30 flights.
We've decided that we have to suspend operations until we have greater certainty over the ash plume over Australia and New Zealand.
Well, we're flying low. There's definitely no ash below 20,000 feet. So for all flights within New Zealand, aircraft are operating at a low altitude, lower than normal.
Planes bound for Queenstown and Wellington were left on the tarmac as some in Sydney abandoned their plans altogether.
We've just made the decision that we'll actually drive back to Canberra and, try again some other time.
Lengthy delays wore thin on those heading across the Tasman from Melbourne.
Tomorrow at 11:40 p.m, so we'll be waiting here a while, it looks like.
Oh, this waiting's ridiculous, aye.
Flights from Perth are only going as far as Melbourne.
Well, it's not something you have much control over, and I think it's better to be safe than be sorry.
The Spirit of Tasmania booking up fast as holiday makers look for ways to cross Bass Strait.
They have to find a way to get us to Sydney, but we don't know yet what's going to happen.
David Woywood, 10 News.
Let's go now to David at Melbourne Airport. David, how bad can this situation get?
Well, Tash, all the major airlines are really unsure exactly how bad this can actually get. Certainly flights now into Melbourne and Sydney have been cancelled as of 6 o'clock, and it's very quiet here inside the terminal at Melbourne Airport. A few of the airlines had been redirecting flights where possible, and a couple of airlines, including Air New Zealand, will continue to make the flight, but flying at much lower altitudes to make sure they get under that big plume of volcanic ash. So while there's looking like being a little bit of a hope for some passengers, it's looking like being a long weekend of long delays for many.
Thank you, David. Let's now go to Sydney Airport, where our reporter is standing by, TEN's Antoinette Latouf. And Antoinette, the delays are certainly bad, but at least some customers will be offered some financial reprieve.
Patash, it's hard to put a monetary figure on a spoilt long weekend, but here's what's on the table. Both Qantas and Jetstar are offering their passengers three options. They'll either issue a refund, a travel voucher, or they'll rebook their flights. Qantas will cover the costs of accommodation, and Jetstar will do the same, provided the passenger doesn't have somewhere to stay in Sydney. Travellers are also urged to check their insurance, as not all policies cover costs incurred due to poor weather conditions.
Thank you so much, Antoinette Latouf, joining us there from Sydney Airport.